here is one more thing that bothers me in the current UX. When I'm filling out a purchase document, I can easily add a service to the list. This obviously doesn't make much sense, so I want to filter all the services out of this list here. We could resolve this by writing some code, but the tasks of this kind are around every corner, so the platform has a setting doing just that. I'm going to the product tabular section of the purchases document and open the product attribute properties. And here is the choice parameters setting. Here I can set up a filter for the products list. So I'm adding a new condition and selecting the product type field on the left. This field will be compared to the value on the right. First, I need to select the right value type, which is EnumRef.ProductTypes. Then I need to select the value, which is product. Okay, let's check how it works. And here we go, no more services in the list. Did we solve the problem? Not really. Let me show you that I can still create a purchase document with a service in it and teach you a couple more things about the script language down the road. So I am creating a new common comment called @purchaseDoc. I need to create a data object, which cannot be done on the client side, so I'm calling a server-side procedure. Now I'm creating the in-memory proxy of the purchase document. This one lives in the server's RAM and didn't make it to the database yet. I will use it to fill out the document attributes like this. And now I'm adding a new line to the products tabular section. And filling it out with the first service I can find. Then I fill out the price and the quantity fields with arbitrary numbers. Then I'm writing the document. This is when it hits the database. And now I inform the user that all is messed up and we have a purchase document with a service in it. Now I'm adding the comment to the other subsystem. And telling the comment that it should go to the normal comment group. Let's check what we have here. This is our comment, I'm running it, refreshing the document list, and this is our broken purchase document. So we prevented the broken purchase documents from being added through UI using this platform setting. But this protection doesn't cover all the cases. We can still write the code that will allow these invalid documents to hit the database. We can fix this particular piece of code. But there are other programmers who have no idea about this ban and who will make similar mistakes over and over again. This, by the way, includes yourself from the future, because you're gonna completely forget about this restriction very, very soon. What we really need here is an unbreakable wall and a single entry point every purchase document has to pass through before it hits the database, so we could check all the documents regardless of where they are coming from and decline all invalid ones. This single entry point lives here in the purchase document object module. And it's called before write event handler. No purchase document makes it to the database without passing through this procedure. So this is where we should write our code. Let's make sure that we get here every time purchase document gets written. I'm going to place the return statement here to make a room for this breakpoint. Now I'm opening the purchase document and posting it. And here we go, the debugger stops at the breakpoint. Okay, now to our add invalid purchase doc command. And we are at the same breakpoint again. Great. Now, how do we call the document been writing right now? Easy. We are inside this document's own method, so it's accessible here by this object name. We are at the breakpoint now, and I can ask the debugger to show me any object content, just like this. So, this is our document, and here is its product list, which I can open too. So, we need to browse through this list and check if there is any services inside. This is how we do that. First off, let's ban empty purchase documents. This is our document, here is its products list, which has the count method, so this is where all empty docs will end up. Okay, what now? How do we cancel the writing? Well, there are several options. First of all, we can use this cancel parameter, like this. And this is what it will look like at the runtime. Not very informative of a message and kinda spooky too. Let's try and show our own message like this. Still the same warning and our message after that. Better, but not that much. Here is a completely different approach. We can ignore the cancel parameter and raise the exception instead. And this is what it looks like. This is definitely better. There are more differences between the cancel parameter and the raise command, but we'll talk about them later. Okay, let's check the contents of the products list, shall we? This is how we browse through the lists. Now I have a single product in this variable, so I can check its type like this and raise an exception if it's a service. Now let's restore the broken version of this code like this. And see what happens. Alright, it works. Awesome. One last thing and we're done with this episode, I promise. We have exactly the same issue with the purchase orders documents. Because we can add a service here. Fixing this, we will end up with this exact code. So we might as well reuse this one, right? All purchase orders attributes have the same names, so I just want to be able to call this exact procedure from two different places, that's all. This is what we use common modules for. They live right here, and you can think of them as of libraries containing reusable procedures and functions. So I'm creating a new module and a new procedure I'm gonna call validate products list. I need to pass the products list to this procedure, so I'm adding a parameter here. I also need it to be accessible from the outside of the module. This is what we use the export keyword for. If I don't put the export keyword here, the procedure will be accessible only from the inside of the module. Now I want to copy this entire code right here and delete this object variable reference. Because the common module does not know who this is. All it knows is this products parameter, which is perfectly enough, checking the syntax, all good. Now I need to call the procedure from the documents module. I'm doing this by the common module's name and then the procedure's name. Then I'm passing this document products list as a parameter here. And we are done. Let's check if it works. Empty document validation. Check. Invalid document validation. Check. Now let's do the same for the purchase orders document. I'm copying this common module procedure call and pasting it right here. Okay, let's see. Empty purchase order. Check. Check. Purchase order with a service.